Welcome back to the STEM Corner, guys. Today we're going to work on our sensory or our touching skills. Here's what we will need. We will need dish soap, water, food coloring, a bowl, and a mixer. To start off, we're going to put some water in our bowl. Let's try to work with little amounts at a time because the solution does quadruple in size, guys. Next, we're going to use our food coloring carefully because it will stain your clothes as well as dye your hands for a period of time. And then I'm going to mix it around or whoosh it around my bowl like so until I have the desired color. Don't forget, you guys can definitely mix your food colorings. Here I'm pretty satisfied, so I'm going to add a little bit of dish soap. Now you can also use washing detergent as well, but this is what I had on hand, and the bottle was smaller. But it works the same. Next, with an adult supervision, I am going to take the mixer, turn it on, and begin to mix up our solution. This is how it will become foam. I've seen multiple people do things on YouTube, like make a bunch of different colors and play Ice Cream Man, where they'll scoop the different color ice cream foam onto actual ice cream cones. But this is not edible, guys. Just an FYI. So I'm going to mix until I feel all of the water at the bottom of the foam is gone or foamy. And then I'm going to play in it. This is a really cool thing to play in. I hope you try it. I hope you enjoy it. And come back next time for some more really cool STEM activities. See you guys. Up next, do you have a minute to win it? Let's play a game and find out. This week's minute to win it is Suck It Up. And what you'll need are some candies like Skittles or M&M's, anything small that can fit with a straw, and a drinking straw. The object is to suck up as many candies from one plate to the other plate in 60 seconds. Failure to do so will result in eliminations. A disclaimer is still due to COVID, let's eat our own candies and do not share. Ready?
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Whoa, 57 seconds. Can you guys beat that? Up next, let's head to the art room. Today we're making spray chalk. So let's get started with our ingredients. First, you'll need some cornstarch, baking soda, you'll need water, a spray bottle to put it in, and your food color. We're going to first start off by adding about 1/3 cup of water into our spray bottle. Depending on how big or how small, you still want to add about 1/3 cup. Or fill it at least 1/3 of the way. Just like this. Next, you're going to add a tablespoon of baking soda and a tablespoon of cornstarch. I have a funnel, which is the green thing on top here that allows me to pour a powder or anything into another container. But you can most definitely use a paper funnel, and they have those on YouTube in case you do not know how to make it. So here I'm just adding my cornstarch, my tablespoon of cornstarch. Next, I'm just going to tap the funnel to make sure that all of my powdered ingredients get into the water. Just just like so. It should look really milky or really powdery. Next, you're going to add a nice amount of food coloring. So the more food coloring that you add, the more vibrant your colors are, or color will be. I'm going to give it a lot of shakes, and then I'm going to go outside and spray. And here you have it, your very own spray chalk. The cool thing about it is that it disappears in about 20 or 30 minutes. So try it out this summer. Let me know how it works and make a bunch of different colors. Take pictures and tag us in them. Really cool, right? Well, that's all for now, and thanks for watching. I hope you guys have a great week and stay safe. See you next time.